My barn paintings are deeply connected to my family and their roots in Eastern Oregon. I've never lived there, but it's always felt like home. It's my mother's country. She was an only child, but her mother was one of nine, and all my mother's aunts and uncles became mine. My grandma Lola was the eldest, and after her sister Ada came seven brothers, and those I knew best were cattle and timbermen. They were men of gentle smiles and bone-crushing handshakes, and they lived quiet, physical lives of hard work close to the land. My aunts used to hug me so hard and long, they made the uncle's handshakes seem gentle. My Aunt Marilyn, gone just last year, was on horseback every chance she got well into her 90s. It was in this country that my love for the natural world was born. I have my Uncle David to thank. He knew the country the way I've always dreamed of knowing a place, and he started me fishing when I was 3 or 4 years old. He took my brother Todd and me all over the county to explore and fish his favorite spots. I was initially drawn to art by my love of the outdoors and the fantasies of my youth, mountain men and cowboys, and the landscapes which they explored. It led me to the work of Frederick Remington and Charles Russell, Winslow Homer and N.C. Wyeth. Their work started me along the path of painting. But along the way, I ran across a Mark Rothko retrospective, and from Rothko to Motherwell, Clifford Still and Richard Diebenkorn, to color fields and textures, motion and abstraction, questioning everything I thought art was to me. Over 20 years ago, I took my wife Darby to meet my family here. We found ourselves in the massive hay barn on the original family homestead. I used to roam around in it as a kid, but with fresh eyes, seeing it all anew, a body of work took shape. Trying to take a common theme and make it something new, to turn a subject of sweet nostalgia and American pie into something contemporary and iconic, representational to an extent, but imbued with color, energy, and surface of expressionism. So when I paint a barn, I keep in mind the heroism of my early influences, the sense of atmosphere, the tactile, textural experience of a place. And I think of the simplicity and monumentality of more modern influences, the tones and textures and color fields of memory. It is an homage to my aunts and uncles, to people like them, to labor and to relationship with land and place, to painting and to our collective history, to memories of the things I love.